Hi, I'm Anita Pointer of the Pointer Sisters, and I'm so excited to be on Celebrity Talk Live with Nicolosi. And I want you to join us. Nicolosi and I will be talking about my new book, Fairy Tale, and our new song release, Feels Like June, and talking about 50 years of the Pointer Sisters. Go to CelebrityTalkLive.com right now and learn how you can join us and watch us live.
Let's get excited.
Welcome to Celebrity Talk Live. I'm your host, Nicolosi, and this is your destination to tune in and tune out. So come join us, share inspiring conversations, Hollywood nostalgia, Q&A, and your chance to disconnect so that we may reconnect. Celebrity Talk Live starts now.
What astonishes me about doing the research about your career is you girls were constantly working. If you weren't performing, you were doing television shows.
We sure were. We were working so much. We were like machines.
Yeah.
We'd be on the road and just work. And just, like I told you, my motto is I can always do one more show. That's what it seems. There's always one more show. And, we would be so exhausted, you know, those first few years, especially when we first started with David Rubinson and had the Fairy Tale and all that. But we would be in interviews and just fall asleep.
Wow.
Because we didn't have any time to sleep. We would be, you know, doing the shows at night and then up in the morning to do the morning shows and the interviews. And they gave us no, we didn't have private jets or people. We didn't even have wardrobe people or hair people at the back in the first days. We were doing our own hair and wardrobe. We finally got a wardrobe person. And our first stop was Washington, D.C., the cellar door.
Okay.
I remember that being our first trip on the road. And our wardrobe lady had a fit and left. She couldn't take it.
Now, was that before,
before
Ola Hudson?
Yes,
okay.
Yes, it was. Actually, it was kind of during the same time because Ola was our designer. She had made these clothes for us to wear at the Troubadour.
Oh, cool.
She was our first designer. She did those clothes that we wore at the Troubadour, the clothes we wore to meet him. Yeah, she was so fabulous.
Yeah.
She just knew what to do, you know, and she kind of copied our style with the kind of 40s look, you know. She made sure she put a little bit of that in there.
Yeah.
But she was incredible. She just come up with some of the most incredible designs for us, and I just love her. And her things are at the museum too, at the Hollywood Museum on the second floor.
Okay.
Yeah, it's one of the first windows you come to.
The entire second floor.
The entire second floor. I met Darnell Danigan at a Roger Neal Oscar party at the museum.
Yes,
and
okay.
I told her what I had, and she came over to the house and saw what I had, and she said, oh my God, this is wonderful. She said, and we had it all so organized. She said, you've done half of the work. So we got this, she said, the whole second floor. And I was really afraid at first. I was, are we going to be able to fill up a whole floor? And it was so much, we had so much stuff. We ended up bringing things back. We couldn't fit on the second floor because it was too much stuff.
Wow.
Yeah.
And Roger Neal's Oscar parties are legendary.
Oh, I'm telling you, they are the best. They really are.
Not to mention,
he has them every year.
His gifting suites.
I know, his gifting suites.
They're awesome.
I love those gifting suites. Free stuff. Are you kidding me?
Uh-huh. How was it that you had the encounter with Carol Burnett?
Oh, boy. Carol Burnett. Oh, how do we get those things with Carol Burnett? What happened? I think it was after Helen Reddy.
Okay.
And so it was after Helen Reddy and Flip Wilson. Then we ended up doing Carol Burnett. Yeah.
And she opened a lot of doors.
They saw us. She did. She opened a lot of doors and taught us a lot, you know, because we were going on the road with all our wardrobe, everything. And she said, no, when you go on the road, it's like going on the road with a play, with a stage play. You have certain outfits that you wear for one song, certain outfits you wear for another song, and that's what you take. You don't take everything. And so we stopped taking. We used to have so many clothes. We have cases that were so huge. And back in the day, we had to bribe the people at the airport to get them on the planes, which is the most ridiculous thing I can think of now ever, to bribe an overweight bag to be on the plane. And they would
Yeah.
do it. They would do it. We put them
While
in their
you're on the same
cases.
plane.
Yes, exactly. These big, huge anvil cases that I have one of them in the exhibit at the museum. I have the music case we used to take on the road with all our cassettes. We had
Sure.
a case that had our cassettes in it and a speaker and you know all that. Oh, and I think about how now it all goes right here on this.
Yes.
You know, we
Yes.
had cases that were huge
Yes.
cases, you
Yes.
know, because we got to take all our music too.
Yeah.
But
Isn't
yeah,
that
I tell you, this
amazing?
new technology is so wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes, even that we can do this with you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you remember that moment?
Carol Burnett, oh my God, she was so much fun working with her. And I also ran into her daughter Carrie at one of the Oscar parties.
Oh,
But
really?
she's, yeah, she called her mom. She said, guess who I'm with? So she, and she sent me some pictures of us together when we were doing the show, and she was a little girl. Her daughter was there, and
Sure.
yeah, Carol Burnett was really a treat. She's so funny and she's so smart, and she's just, you know, her show just ran like clockwork. Wasn't
Yes.
no messing around. They were so organized and beautiful. I just re really enjoyed working with her because everything was perfect, you know. The
Well,
wardrobe with Bob Mackie doing the wardrobe. Are you kidding?
yeah.
Bob Mackie, oh my God, we got to wear Bob Mackie's clothes. And that was the,
Didn't Bob
I'm
Mackie
sorry.
design a piece for Tim Conway to be in your show?
Yes. We went on the road with Carol Burnett. We went to Vegas and Tahoe with her. And June, that was one of the times when June was ill. She wasn't there with us. And Bob Mackie made a dress exactly like the ones me and Ruth and June were, and me and Bonnie were wearing. And had Jim, I mean, Tim come on stage as the fourth Pointer sister in this dress that looked just like ours. And it was so hilarious. He would crack, the audience would just die every night. They would just die seeing him in that dress that looked just like ours. So funny. He was a great talent too.
Yeah,
He was
he was.
laughing.
Yeah.
Yes, he
Well, that
was.
show, Carol Burnett's show was literally every episode was like a Broadway production, a full-on production.
That's the truth. And they treated it like that. It was serious business.
Yeah.
You know, it was serious. We had 4 days of rehearsal, and on the fifth day, you had two tapings. And
Wow.
everything was like clockwork. I just was so admire. I admire her so much for just being so wonderful and organized and everything just being so, you know, fabulous when we work with her.
Well, and she also
Yeah.
set the tone in the beginning of that show. You know, Harvey Korman, who was very talented, had a little bit of a diva air to him, and Carol set that straight right out the gate, said, "This is how you treat everybody around here, and we all treat each other
Oh.
with respect." And she demanded that every n nobody was better than anybody else, and
Isn't that simple?
everybody worked.
I
Yeah.
never knew that. I never knew Harvey had any social problems, but
Well, I think it was just that he felt like, you know, he was one of the co-stars, and so this is probably
Right.
how he's going to behave. And Carol just said, "No, that's not how it is around here. We all work together." And I applaud her because she
I
didn't
do
have to say,
too. Isn't that wonderful?
"Yeah."
That is so fabulous because we never had
Well,
any problems. None.
I thought of you when I was doing my research, interesting serendipity, when I did the portrait for Floyd Mayweather and Mike Tyson when they were inducted into the Hall of
Do our portrait.
Let's do it.
All right.
I
Do
did.
you do a portrait? I'm sorry, go on.
Well, it was cool because that was right at the end. The other person being inducted, it was unfortunately right at the end of his life, and he couldn't make it to Vegas, but his daughter Rashida autographed Muhammad Ali, her father's portrait. So we unveiled it with Rashida and her two boys, Biagi, who's a football player, who would have been Muhammad's grandson.
Oh my goodness.
Half Italian and half black, and they're gorgeous.
Oh, I know they're beautiful.
They got the best of both.
I'm telling you, that mixture is always comes so beautiful. My sister has an Italian husband, and their kids are just gorgeous.
Right. Yeah.
Yes. Beautiful. Connor and Allie, they're the most so beautiful kids.
And do they live in California or?
No, they live in Boston.
Oh,
in Massachusetts.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Is that where he's from?
Some of her Ruthie's kids, her other three kids live in, well, two of them live in California and one lives in Vegas.
Oh, geez. All spread out.
And yeah, they're all grown now.
And you had quite a wonderful experience with the Muhammad Ali Foreman fight that you didn't quite make it to.
I know, we went to Africa. Oh my God, what an experience that was. It was so wonderful. Oh my God. And when we got there, it was like Hollywood in Africa because everybody was there. Sister Sledge, Curtis Mayfield. God, I can't even think of all the people right now, but it was just so many. Bill Withers.
Oh, Ali. Love Bill Withers.
And Ali would invite us to go to his training camp every day. He would send people to pick us up and take us to watch him train.
Wow.
And we would go every day. And then he also invited us to be his escort, or he was our escorts, to go into the stadium when they had a night of performances. I can't even remember. I think that was the night Curtis Mayfield performed. But anyway, when we walked into that stadium with Ali, it was unbelievable. The people were so insane over him. Even when we were driving, you know, in the car going to his camp, the kids would be falling in the streets trying to get to his pictures. They were throwing pictures of Ali out the window.
Wow.
And they were trying to get to his pictures, and they would just fall into the streets just trying to get close to Ali. And they didn't like George Foreman so much because he brought German shepherds over, his dogs.
Oh,
and they
really?
Said that the African people didn't like the dogs because that's the way they used to be rounded up and imprisoned by, you know, the guards would use dogs to capture them and stuff. And so they didn't like those German shepherds. So I guess George didn't know that when he brought his dogs over, but nobody had too much to say to him. But Ali, oh my God, he was like a god over there. He really was. He just, they worshiped him.
Well, just that, I remember just this whole persona, I'm the greatest, and his press conferences were entertainment.
He was the first boxer that I ever paid attention to because my brothers used to, you know, they were all in the box every Monday night. I think it was the Pabst Blue Ribbon beer, and they would play that commercial, that Pabst Blue Ribbon commercial and the Gillette commercial, and my brothers and my dad and them would take over the TV. We only had one TV in the house, of course. So it was all boxing, but when Ali came along, oh my God, he was so funny. He was cute too. He wasn't as cute as he said he was. He was so funny. I just loved him, you know, and I got to meet him. And when we did the Mike Douglas show in Philadelphia, they asked, we co-hosted for a week.
Wow.
And when they asked us, who did we want to have on the show? Ali was one of the people we wanted to have on the show because my daddy wanted to meet him. And they got him. And they had our mom and dad on the show.
Oh.
They had Ali on the show. Angela Davis, I think she was on the show. And my cousin Paul, who was playing pro basketball at the time, he got
Celtic.
On the show. Yeah, he was with the Celtics, the Boston Celtics, yeah.
Really? That's your cousin?
Yeah, Paul Silas. That's my mother's brother's son. And they lived in the same house we did growing up. They were downstairs. We were upstairs.
Wow. Yeah. Now, was that during the time that Bill was the coach?
Paul was the coach. He was the coach later on. No, that was later on. When he was out of high school and college. And he played pro ball for quite a while, too. Paul did. And then he became a coach. And he coached LeBron James his first professional year in Cleveland. And shortly after that, Paul retired.
Okay.
So he's retired now.
And were you in Africa while he was training, were you there before the fight was postponed or after? Because there was a
before.
Oh, there
yeah,
was.
We got, yeah, we were there before because we were toured. We were booked to go to Europe after Africa.
Okay.
So we had to go on. Oh my God, what a time that was. I remember spending the night on that Congo River and seeing those guys come through with their boats and seeing the sun coming up. It was, and I didn't even have a camera. Can you believe that? No camera. Go to Africa without a camera. Oh my God. But in those days, I didn't, you know, I didn't have money. I didn't have a camera. I didn't have a lot of things, you know?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We just went, the memories though are just so beautiful. And
yes.
We were trading hats and t-shirts for malachite and ivory because they loved American t-shirts and hats and stuff.
Wow.
And it was just unbelievable how beautiful the country was. It was the most beautiful place I'd ever seen in my, and still to this day, ever seen in my life. Because there was so much land.
Yeah.
So much beautiful green land, just, you know, roads, just hillsides and hillsides. And it was just, and people, so many people just walking. They weren't a whole lot of cars. There were a lot of people walking. But
now,
Africa was,
you went on tour after you had left there. Was that when you received your Billie Holiday Award in France?
Yes, I think that was. We were on our way to Europe after that award, after the fight. The fight hadn't happened. We left. And we received the Billie Holiday Award in Paris. We sure did. We sure did. It was fabulous. And we're real honored to have that. Yeah.
Congratulations. That's a huge
honor. Thank you. Thank you.
And some of the people that you had listened to when you were a child and you looked up to when you were a child, you ended up working with.
Oh yeah, that's so true. That's so true.
Aretha.
Aretha, we didn't really, well, we worked with her. We did some shows together, you know, that we were both on the same show.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And oh God, what are some of the other people that we worked with? Gladys Knight, we did Christmas, I think some Christmas thing with her.
Mm-hmm.
And the Temptations, we worked with them. We opened for the Temptations here at the Universal Amphitheater when we first started.
That's awesome.
Work with the OJs and
oh yeah,
you know, we work with them and Kool and the Gang. I remember having some really fun shows with Kool and the Gang over at Amsterdam. Yeah, I did get a chance to work with some of the people I really loved and admired, and that was really good thing to have happen in my life.
And do you girls get together ever and perform?
Nope.
No.
Well, me and Bonnie, every now and then, me and Bonnie will do something, award show or some, you know, something like that, where we just sing one or two songs.
Awesome.
And we've done that for a couple of years now. Me and Bonnie showed up at different awards and things and given awards out. And
great.
But I've got kind of done with performing.
Well, with that being said, all you have to do is walk on stage. That's all you have to do.
Well, who knows? I won't say never because I
That's
don't
right.
know. You know, sometimes I feel like singing. I really do. And I will.
Yeah.
I'll sing when I feel like singing.
Yeah.
But, you know, doing a show with me and Bonnie and Ruthie, you know, that could be something that I would consider.
Yeah. Just the first few bars of any of your songs. With
I know. It would be so fabulous because we're so good together. We really are. And, you know, I don't know why, you know.
Well, and I think too, you've made it through so much. You've worked so hard, and that's such an inspiration to young people. And that's was really the birth of this talk show, Celebrity Talk Live, was I couldn't get out to do the interviews that I normally do in people's homes or red carpets or on stage or whatever. And so I felt so underutilized, and it felt like the world was imploding. And that's why I love talking to people like you, because you have the coping skills on how to survive, because you did it. You worked hard, you survived. What do you call upon for your coping skills to survive in the present world that we're living in right now?
What do I call on?
Like where do you find your strength to get through this current crisis that's the scourge of the world, of the entire planet?
I know. I really w look to my mom and dad still. I really do. I kind of lost my religion when my daughter died, and I just can't seem to get back to that. I just feel so bad about it because I never thought I'd feel this way. But I find strength in just talking to my mom and dad. I really do. And I picture them right in my room, and I talk to them almost every day. And so
That's
that's where I get
amazing.
the strength from. And from the people that are around me that I know care about me and love me, my granddaughter Roxy, and my friends Paula and Carol, and so I just depend on them for inspiration. And my brothers, of course, I talk to my brothers all the time, Fritz and Aaron, and
How
my
was
dear
it?
friend Melissa. Melissa put this book, Melissa and Bont and Roxy, they did this book for me.
That was just my
And
next
it's
question. Your that was my
really
yeah.
okay.
Both of your books. And then I also want to talk about can how people can order them where you would autograph a copy for them. Is that something that would be the AnitaPointer.com website?
Yes, AnitaPointer.com. I will sign it and mail it to you. And the same thing
Wonderful.
with the Ever After book is only digital.
Okay.
It's on my website. You can look at it digital, but it's great. It's got all the clothes that are at the on the exhibit at the Hollywood Museum.
Okay.
Those are
And
in
this
there. And
fairy tale is the one that's on your website that's written by your with you and your brother Fritz. This one.
yes,
Okay.
that's our book, Fairy Tale. And it took a while to get to it because my brother is a writer, and he's telling me, well, writing is rewriting. So we were writing and rewriting and writing and rewriting. I, oh, Fritz, wait. But we got it down. Finally, we got it. And it's really a beautiful, easy to read story. It's perfect for this time when you're home and you want something to do. Oh my God,
Wonderful.
what a great time to read Fairy Tale. It's just such a great, wonderful book. And it's, like I said,
Wonderful.
it's easy reading, and it's fun, and it's challenging. So,
When
oh, I
did
got
it
to put my
come
hands
out?
down. You can see my nails.
Yeah.
I haven't
When
had
did
my nails done in 2 months.
They're not on
This
camera.
top is not fitting right for some reason. Okay, that's better. I'm sorry,
And
what?
when did your book, when was it released?
It was released February 11th.
Wow, right
And
before
we were planning our book signing at the Hollywood Museum. We were planning book signings at the Oakland Museum and in San Francisco at bookstores and Berkeley at bookstores. We had it all lined up. And then everything stopped.
Where
So
we're going to put your link on some on the show's website, and when we do the actual live broadcast of this show, I'll work with Roger to do a big press release. And we're partnering with another theater. It's a huge auditorium that has season ticket holders. I'll reach out to him. He's a very, very nice man, and see if we can't get some synergy to help them to promote your book on that as well.
Yay, thank you so much. I'd
Yeah,
love
you gave me
that.
a brilliant idea when you and I spoke last. I took your advice and I went back and listened to your newly released song, and I cannot get it out of my head.
Oh, yay.
Is this
Feels
your
like
great?
I swear I wake up every morning with that song in my head. I do.
I can't get it out of my head. It's
I just
wonderful.
I'm so happy.
And is this your
Isn't it great?
is this the latest release of yours and Bonnie's?
Yep.
Oh,
Yes, it
that's
is. It's the latest
awesome.
release. We wrote it last year. Actually, I started it quite a few years ago with Steve Diamond. He had sent me the track, and I wrote the lyrics, and then I got with Bonnie last the end of last year, and we finished it. And Steve came in. He lives in Nashville. He came in, and I have a little studio here at the house, so we went in there and recorded, and it's just great. I just love it so much.
Who did the beautiful video work? It's amazing.
Isn't that great? I had a friend named Santiago, and
Okay.
he got it done for me. And his friends, I can't remember his friend's name that do the one of the videographers or what, but I can't remember his name. But Santiago put it together
Oh,
for the
wonderful.
video. And yeah,
Wonderful.
I thought it was so nice. I thought it
Is
was
that
really,
on
really
your that's
nice.
on your website as well?
Yes, it
Okay.
sure is. It's on anitapointer.com and pointersisters.com.
Great. Well,
And
what I'm going to
yeah.
do, Anita, is we thought of airing this show next week, but in honor of your sister, I'd like to air
Sure.
it the first week of June.
That would be wonderful. And we were saying we wanted to promote it more for June because June is next month, and that'd be fabulous. I
Good.
love that.
Good. I can't
Yes.
I can't get it
Oh, I
out of
love
my
it.
head. It's brought me a lot of comfort because obviously
Oh.
I could see the love of the sisters, not only in the lyrics, but in the
Yeah.
video. Those clips of you in the studio together, I was sobbing.
Oh, I've had several friends tell me that when I sent it to them, they cried because June was such a sweet girl. And, she worked her whole life. She started when we went on the road as backup singers, me and Bonnie June. She was like 15. She quit school and went on the road with us, and I treated her like my child. I really did. I looked out for her and tried to anyway, tried my best to make sure she was okay. And she was. During those years, she was fine. We lived together in San Francisco, and me and Bonnie and June had a great time. We really did.
That's the hard
Yeah.
part as we get older is, you question a lot of things, and that's the hardest part is that you come to the realization that this life, a lot of it is about loss.
Yeah.
God,
Yeah.
that's a tough,
I.
but you did a beautiful
Yeah.
job honoring your sister, and I'd like to air the show in June in honor of your sister.
Thank you so much. I
You're welcome.
love
Can
it.
we indulge our audiences? I have
Thank
a
you,
small
Nico.
clip of your video if you'd like to. I'd love to share it with the audience now if you have about 90 seconds.
Oh, yes. Oh, for sure.
All right,
Please do.
I've been thinking about you. Can't help thinking about you. You're so much a part of who I am. Looking at me, I see you there. Sometimes it hurts, but still I stare. I just want so much to understand. Why the flowers grow, the rivers flow, the birds sing sweeter too. Just because they all feel privileged to feel the light from you feels like June. Happy as the sky, without a reason why. She can make you laugh until you cry. Feels like June. Everywhere I go, people wanna know, why'd you have to leave so soon? Feels like June.
Have you done this a time or two?
Yeah.
Nice job. Nice job.
Oh,
Oh, I
good.
can't tell you how much I enjoyed this.
Oh, I did too. I did too. You're so sweet. I can't wait to see you.
You. I feel the same, and I did my homework and it paid off, and
You sure did.
have
It
a
was.
lovely, a wonderful life that you should be very, very proud of.
Thank you so much. Thank
All
you.
right,
I
my dear.
really appreciate this.
I do
One of my
too.
favorites of all time,
Oh, thank you. All right, get
Nicolosi.
a nice big Sicilian hug for that.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. I can't wait for my hug.
All
Oh
right,
my
all right.
God, I need a
All right,
hug.
thank you, Roxy.
So thank you,
All right,
Roxy.
God bless you, Anita.
Thank you. God
Bye-bye.
bless you too. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you again, everyone, for joining us today, and a very special thanks to Ms. Pointer. Please tune in next week at the same time, 7 p.m. Central, 5 p.m. Pacific, and 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Remember, every episode of Celebrity Talk Live during the entire month of June, we are dedicating to the release of Ms. Pointer's new song, Feels Like June, which she penned with her sister Bonnie to honor the legacy of their beautiful youngest sister, June, who left us in 2006. You can also listen to Feels Like June and order your own autographed copy of her book, Fairy Tale, which she co-wrote with her brother Fritz, by visiting her website, anitapointer.com. Thank you all again. Thank you, Ms. Pointer, and see you next week. Be kind.